everyone, and welcome to another Back to Business video. I'm Nate Wendt, Tourism and Sales Coordinator for the St. Charles Business Alliance. Also repping the Alliance is our Executive Director, Jenna Sawicki.
Hello.
We have a great episode here for you today as we're joined here with the St. Charles Chamber of Commerce. We're here represented with Jim Jatala, here as the President and CEO of the Chamber. Jim, thanks for joining us today. We're excited to have you on. How are you doing?
Great. Thanks for having me. I was really honored to be here, and I'm excited for the conversation. So,
yeah. Absolutely.
You know, on this great fall day.
Yes, it's a beautiful fall day. Unfortunately, we've had some snow here that makes it feel like winter, but we're going to make the most of it.
Exactly.
So before we get into talking about the Chamber, let's talk about you. So tell us about yourself, how long you've been president at the Chamber, time you've been in St. Charles, you know, things like that.
Well, I have been in the St. Charles area for over 20 years, and I've been downtown St. Charles proper in Ward 4 for the last 4 years. I have a daughter who recently graduated college and is employed for a division of Nordstrom, so excited that she's able to get some opportunity during these crazy times. So that's great. I spent over 30 years, and it's almost 35 years, in financial services. I started in a high school work program and then have been worked my whole life with a almost 30-year career at BMO Harris. And a lot of my background experiences in strategy, execution, customer experience, and I did a lot of managing North American teams and how we brought different products and services to the organization and to our customers. I'm community focused, very big on local non-for-profits and being engaged in the community. And what's really nice about being in a community where you work, where you're part of the nonprofits, I was commuting downtown Chicago for over 30 years. Ouch. And did some nonprofit work in the city because that was my company, right? But the meaningfulness of being in your community and seeing people in the stores and at church and at events and working with partners like yourself is just a really great feeling on a day-to-day basis. It's part of your life. It's not like work is something else and your community is something else. It's really together. And so I started at the Chamber in early 2018. It seems a lot longer, especially this year, but it's only been a few years, and it's really great to be part of the community and to serve the community that I love and call home.
Yeah, so we know the Chamber's been really busy and working really hard to support all of our local businesses. So can you give us an overview and kind of dive into the things that you guys have been doing, especially with the pandemic?
Sure. So funny, as we were talking about earlier, we've all been forced to change the crazy word of pivot.
Yes.
the overused.
Yes.
But we're really, as a Chamber, we have a business to run, and our business is supporting our business community, right? And so we've had a look at ourselves to understand our customer and their needs during this time, and how do we respond? You know, as a Chamber, we provide tools, services, program, and events that enable our members to connect, whether it's to information, tools, resources, each other, the community. And that point of connection became even more important, especially in the time where we're living like this in a virtual world in many cases. And so early on, one of the things we did was the connection part was about information. It was coming so fast and rapid. And as we worked on some of these things together, you know, we needed to find ways of getting it out to the business community. So one of the things was really ramping up the homepage of our website and organizing the amount of information that was coming to us so that it could be meaningful to our members on the other end as they went and looked for things that they were looking for. We also, and it's probably a really cool moment in challenging times, put together a Business and Economic Revival Council, which is made up of seasoned experts across what I call like the business model or operating model. So we have someone in strategy and finance and HR, operations, education, the health department, supply chain management, manufacturing, and the like. And so this group of attorneys and accountants and entrepreneurs and specialists came together early on and became some eyes and ears for what are they seeing, but more so because of the business that they're in, what are they seeing from their various clients? Because they all, right. most of them had clients. So we were getting, in addition to our own members and our leadership team, a whole nother set of input about what was important and needed. And that led to a series of information that was put on the website, white papers, webinars, etc. And this team was also helpful in humanizing. I've been trying to avoid the word manning because it's men and women. So humanizing our helpline. we have a dedicated member helpline. And they could inquire and we navigate where they could go for resources. And this council, you know, we put it together. And it's really advisors, almost like consultants to the chamber and our members. So that's a way that we've been able to do it. A lot of focus on their businesses, right? So where there's a lot of effort in networking connections, which are important for businesses that were going really well, the need to refocus on their business wasn't as important, but everyone was caused to revisit their business and their business model. So topics like, of course, PPP loans, but sales and cash flow management and change management and working at home. And what's that mean for how I lead my company? Hosted a number of different conversations and workshops in that place. We're also, as you have as well, really trying to figure out ways to help our members keep their brands alive and out there during these times where relevant. And so a number of things on that front. And then legislatively, clearly we've kept a lot, we have built some good relationships with our legislators. That became really important throughout this process and is where we are today. And then in addition, hosted a number of meet the candidate forums and really good conversations about the progressive income tax or flat tax or and it was fascinating because it was the, you know, we had both sides represented so mm-hmm. people could better understand, and that information became even more important if you will.
Yeah, and I know that everyone has really appreciated you guys because, you know, I know things right now managing PPP grants, you know, all the different mitigation efforts has been tough. So having you guys as a resource to be able to, you know, go to ask these questions is invaluable. So I keep up the great work because you guys are doing phenomenal. Over
there. Thanks, Nate. And really it's the members, right? I'm not the expert at all, but what it is we're a conduit to making sure that the members who have this experience, and they're so generously willing to share their time and expertise with each other so that they don't have to, you know, walk by themselves. And to me, that's a really cool thing to see how they work together.
Yeah, business supporting business, you know,
yes.
It's, you know, terrific to see. So, and I know there's another way that you guys are supporting business with your chamber gift card program. Can you guys talk about that as well?
Yeah, so our chamber gift card program, thanks for asking, is a new program. It's replaced what was the gift certificate program. And that was really kind of archaic. So what had to happen is people would come in, have to get a paper certificate. They pay for it. You go to a local business. They accept it. You cannot get change back. Then they submit it back to the chamber so that we could write them a check and so forth. So that just seemed like a lot of work for 2020. So right. We now have really nice, I should have pulled one out. You know, it looks like a credit card, chamber gift cards. You could purchase them online and we could even mail them to the recipient. So if it was like a gift and we've had several people from out of town find us on the website. They wanted to give a gift of something local for their family member or a friend. Right. And then we just mail it with a gift card to the local resident, or they could pick it up at the chamber. And so it's been serving really well. We are, using that for the holiday season. So in our new community guide and membership directory, which will come out in a couple of weeks, we have a section dedicated to our whole theme of shop local, support local, and then we added the idea of gift local for the holiday season, shows the gift cards so that we could put those dollars back in our members' hands. We also are showcasing the shop local, gift local, where we have a dedicated page on our website, and members could come up with member offers like baskets or things where the community could come in and actually purchase them through the online in order to raise the visibility of our members and their offers. And we even just one example, this just went out to, it's our kickoff. It went out to a special thing in Money Mailer for the shop local, gift local. So we're trying to put it in as many areas as we can.
Yeah.
N2 Publishing is coming out with also a new community guide across the Fox Valley, and we've put in there trying to drive people back to the businesses and to shop local and support local, and those are going to all new homeowners across the Fox. So that launches next in November.
That's so wonderful that you guys made that update to the Chamber gift card, because I just think that is going to make everything so much easier. And I think that your banking background probably helped you out a little bit on that. And I just think that's so great that you're able to pull in all of your knowledge and update that whole system. I think that's so cool.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, we've gotten good feedback, and it is, that process was a little archaic, and it's also what's hard for the businesses, because as you have turnover on your front line.
Yeah, I was going to say that, the trickle down.
Explain, right? Like, well, what's this piece of paper and what do I do with it? What do you mean I can't give change? And they're not really prepared, right?
We're right.
Not swipe it, move on. The business may not even know it's a gift card, you know, necessarily.
Yeah, I was wondering, because we have that sometimes too with some of our program going on, like the owner or the GM or whoever might want to be a part of the program or whatever, but then, like, you know, they have a new hire who's like, what is this? I have no idea, you know? So that's great that you guys made it so easy and streamlined. I think that's fantastic.
Thank you. And we did that with a member partner. So see, they help us move things along.
That's awesome.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Break Between the Podcasts. This is Nate Wendt, your guide to all things St. Charles and your very best friend. I want to thank you all for tuning in to our Back to Business video here with Jim T'Challa from the Chamber. He's done a phenomenal job, and it's great to see all the things that they're doing to support local. I hope everyone takes that to heart. Let's do what we can to support local, help get these businesses through these tough times. So we have an upcoming event coming up on November 27th and 28th, which is Holiday Homecoming. It's going to be a great event with the Friday. We're going to have a virtual lighting of the light ceremony. And then Saturday, we're going to have a whole myriad of events for people to be able to come explore. One event we'd like to promote during that weekend is the Holiday Tree Trail. If you would like to join on the Holiday Tree Trail by coming and decorating a tree over on the First Street Riverwalk, we are accepting applications until November 13th. You can find more information about that and the rest of our events going on that weekend at www.stcholidayhomecoming.com. So thank you all again for tuning into the Back to Business video here. We're going to get back into the action as we talk more with Jim about what they're doing to support local. So let's go back to find out what's up downtown. Awesome.
Well, you guys obviously love to support local, and you do, and you love to help with all you can do. So let's talk about the importance of shopping local this holiday season and in general. I mean, you talked about your shop local card, but and you mentioned Money Mailer. You know, anything else you wanted to kind of dive into a little bit deeper?
Well, I think our membership directory, there's a few spots reinforcing the shop local. We also have a big billboard out in the corner of our building that says shop local, support local, and we actually have yard signs. And so we still have some left if anyone wants some yard signs to put out in front of their business or their home to continue to support local. That is the message. And any chance we can to reinforce that message.
Yeah.
I will tell you, I have a connection to one of the news anchors, and I'm so sick of the stories about online and Amazon made you know, be slow in getting stuff. I ordered a couple things from a business that I'm still waiting on that was a special order that it's still slow. And I'm like, I want you to do a program on shop small and support local, because this is what needs to happen this holiday season. We need to think about all the ways we could. It's easy to go online in the middle of the night when we can't sleep to go buy, but we need to find ways to help our business community stay afloat until things get to the other side.
Absolutely.
And whatever that looks like. And we're just integrating messaging, as I know you are as well, wherever we can.
We're definitely in step with that of like, we're pushing real hard this, you know, holiday season. Is if you want to see these guys keep their doors open, guess what? You got to support local.
Yeah.
And we're working on some messaging too. And it's really great to hear that we're so in tune with that. So
yeah, for sure. We are, and it's not executed yet. So, but just on the radar is there is a program that we want to launch starting on Small Business Saturday that hopefully would last through the holiday season. We're playing with a couple of ideas. It's just another way to encourage people to shop local. So
that's great. And Laura, who works with us, you know, that is our kind of, she's our Small Business Saturday ambassador through American Express. So we'd love to partner on anything that you guys have.
Yeah, that would be cool.
Yeah. So if anyone is looking to kind of get more involved with the chamber, learn more, what's the kind of the best way to find more information about all of you guys?
Honestly, the best way is to go to stcharleschamber.com. And you could click on the membership tab and you get a really good overview, details and benefits and the way we help, what's right for a member. You know, it's interesting. We just did a member satisfaction survey and it's not completed yet, but I was so excited to see that one of the number one high level tools that the members like is the website as a resource. And, you know, the board made a significant investment for an organization of our size to redo that website and to make it the tool that it is today. And so to see the survey come back that they actually are enjoying and using it for what we designed it to be, it was really encouraging. And members provided the input to it as well. So I'm a big believer of it's not our ideas. We're just trying to help get our customers in. So we know what to push back out and how we can support them. And so that website is current. It has all the latest information, and that there's a video on the membership. When you click on the member page that you go to, there's an overview video and a really nice synopsis about what membership means. So that's the best place. And obviously they can always call us or stop in and we're happy to review that with them.
Awesome. That's great.
Absolutely. Is there anything else that you would like to share about the chamber, Jim, while we have you here on our Zoom call?
You know, I think I'd just like to reinforce the fact that it's about connecting, and it's all about how we can connect our members to not only information and tools and resources, but to each other and to the community. And it's fascinating. I have a few examples during this time. You know, I feel like the more you know about our members, the better I can help guide them. And so in a confidential setting, I'll just give you some boundaries. A member called who had some capacity, available resources because of what was happening to their business model. Might they be able to assist given their skills, knowledge, with another member who might need some resourcing? Well, we were able to make that connection, and now they have a partnership going with one another, helping each other in a time of need, so to speak. And there was it's kind of like supply and demand, and how do you put them together? Yesterday I had a call from a new member who was trying to connect. He has some ideas about how he could showcase his work by engaging with the artist community. I'm like, oh, well, I'll introduce you to the Art Council and to this artist and, you know, et cetera. How do we help them? And so I think if the more we could connect with our members and the more they connect with us and that we know about people, the closer it becomes, the world becomes smaller, and we're able to help each other through the journey. And now more than ever, it's most important.
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. And that collaboration is huge, and especially as it builds community. And, you know, our next question leads to community, as we want to ask you, you know, is there anything that you'd like to say to the St. Charles community during this time?
You know, I love it here. So it's home. It's a great place to call home, and it's a great place to serve. And I just hope that we could all bond together and just really support one another during the journey, because it is a journey. None of us have been here before. We're going to make some mistakes. So I hope there's grace given in that process. But I think it's about the heart of what we're all trying to do. And if we could have that heart for one another and for our business community and helping us through these times, I think it's more important than ever. And I hope, if anything, when we get to the other side, which I believe will be changed forever, that doesn't necessarily mean bad. There are just things we learn through this that will change how we go about doing business. And, you know, there are some good things, some very effective things about Zoom. I don't want it to be every meeting that we're in, but there are some really great things that we've learned, like with our legislative Meet the Candidates. That used to be an in-person forum, and in a lot of cases, it was a bunch of handshakes, and you got to see the people. Now you actually got to hear from them and have a two-way dialogue that wouldn't have been possible without a Zoom format. And so I think we will be fundamentally changed, but I hope what's really changed is our hearts for what's really important and how a local community working together can really drive the local economy and support one another and our families and the community that we serve.
Absolutely.
Well, Jim, talking on the other side, you've made it through our gauntlet of questions. We're now on the safe side of all of them. So awesome job. Way to go.
Thank you.
We do have one more question for you. Are you ready, though?
I'm ready.
All right. So we like to ask this everyone who comes on the podcast. So if you were a king of St. Charles for a day, what would be your first proclamation and why?
Proclamation. So I would like to say that I would proclaim that we've eliminated COVID. But I don't
think
the King of St. Charles would have that in their power to do so. So I think I would build upon the prior conversation we just had. And I think it's about being kind and respectful and sensitive to one another. We're all in this together. We're all facing difficult times. There's not only the business element, but our families and the personal mental health is being impacted at such a huge degree. It's things going on in the world are dividing us on the national and local level. And I think everyone,
just a day to like step away from it all.
Step away.
Yeah.
And be respectful of views and opinions. Mm-hmm. There's no reason not to be kind and respectful. It's okay if we don't agree, but we're all walking with something right now, and we're walking with a lot of heavy burdens. So I would like to take that away for a day, and let's just enjoy the humanness of one another.
I love that. Absolutely. Great answer, Jim. And your answers, they were terrific. So that wraps up our video here. So we want to thank you very much for taking time out of your busy schedule to come.
I really enjoyed it. And I'm thankful that we were able to have this opportunity. Thanks for inviting me.
Of course. So we will have more Back to Business videos to come. You can find those on our social media. Until then, everyone, stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you all next time.
Bye.
Take care. Bye.